The height and repeat values applied to any reprofile has dramatic effects on the end result. This tutorial concentrates on these values plus the ability to define and apply default values for consistency and convenience. I will use a custom bicycle chain profile as a demonstration. We can see in this artwork that the chain is currently represented by a single closed path with a thick black stroke. By holding down the Option Alt key modifier, I can drag out a looped mode reprofile. Whilst the mouse is still held down, along with the key modifier, I can also press the D key to set the height and repeat to the default currently defined in the profile attributes. Numeric control of the height is available in the panel. In this example, I only have the single loop height control, but if I drag out another offset marker, that is now possible to numerically define in the panel too. To be sure you're controlling the right marker, you can simply click to select it first. Whereas the height of the profile can be defined both visually and numerically, control over the number of repeats is only available numerically in the panel. The distance value for repeat represents the total length for a single profile instance. If the path it gets applied to is shorter, the profile will be squashed to fit. You cannot apply a partial profile. Decreasing the repeat distance value will increase the number of profile instances that can fit. Caution in reducing the value so low that too many repeats are attempted, as this can severely slow the tool down. Conversely, increasing the repeat value will reduce the number of profiles that are able to fit and will result in each profile stretching out where possible. Remember that the break option will affect the result. Please watch a separate tutorial covering this. For the chain profile, it looks good, but the default values have scaled it up too much for this particular artwork. If you're drawing artwork consistently at the same scale, for example for architecture or fashion technical packs, setting the default that suits you can be very useful. As the proportion of each chain link looks correct, notice how each link's hole appears circular, I'll reduce both the height and repeat values by thirds. Now the chain looks in proportion with the bike and gears. Before applying this, if I want to ensure that any default use of the chain link profile in the future results in this scale, I can double click on the profile in the panel. This brings up the profile attributes window where the default values are declared and editable. I'll copy over the same values and click OK. I can now apply the reprofile by clicking on the apply button and set the resultant artwork style to default in the native graphic styles panel. My chain link profile is updated and ready to be reapplied in any other Illustrator file I work in.